Hey guys, welcome back to another video here on Toned In Entertainment, where we love pop culture. Today, it's time for another comic book review as we take a look at a new series by AfterShock Comics. Now, will I be able to recommend this comic, or will I wish I had psychic powers and avoided this one in the first place? Well, let's get on with my comic book review for Phantom on the Scan, issue number one. While there are several people, at least four, that we will meet here in issue number one that have developed some type of psychic abilities after a comet fell to Earth 20 years ago, the story will really focus around Matthew Jordan, or Matt as he likes to be called, and him trying to hold on to not only what sanity he has left, but his life force as well, as he believes that the psychic abilities he has, the more he uses them, the weaker he gets, which will ultimately lead to his demise. Matt will use his psychic abilities to reach out to the other three that are in the same boat as him to try and figure out the missing pieces of the puzzle in their lives. But for these four, the tie that binds them is coming for them, and whatever it is, well, it's not very fond of them. Now, I really do enjoy going into my comic book store and finding a new series on the shelf and picking it up if I think it's something that's going to intrigue me. Just like you guys, I put down my money for these comics to review, and I'm only going to pick up comics I think I'm going to enjoy. But after reading Phantom on the Scan, issue number one, it just really didn't do it for me. So my final score is going to be a 5 out of 10. Now, there are some great panels here, especially when it's illustrated with someone hearing the voices in their head. Plus, there's times they go with an interesting art style, which almost looks like smudges when Matt is talking to the mysterious child he hears voices from. But honestly, with so many comics out there to read and so little time, issue number one of Phantom on the Scan just didn't do anything to hook me, as it really felt underwhelming. Now, in addition to the story being underwhelming, well, you're also gonna have to pay a dollar more for this issue than your standard comic, as Phantom on the Scan issue number one does go for $4.99. And honestly, I don't know why it goes for a dollar more, as there's not really a lot of meat here in issue number one, and you can finish reading book number one in a blink of an eye. Now again, Phantom on the Scan wasn't a bad read. It was just average. There is some potential there, but it really did nothing to hook me. And honestly, this is gonna be one of those comics that, unfortunately for me, is completely forgettable. Now, did you read this issue? And if you did, what are your thoughts? Did you enjoy it? If you did, leave me a comment down below. And guys, if you like comic book reviews like this, make sure you stay tuned in here to Toned In Entertainment for future videos.
Subscribe to the channel. Do it. Go now. Do it now.